channel. My name is Sylvia. Welcome back to Lucia Divina. Finally, I'm sitting down and I'm recording a video. I feel so weird. Yes. Before I start this video, I want to apologize for all of the issues with my last videos, like my last 2 to 3 or 4 or 5 videos. I've had a big problem with my the software that I edit my video with. Every time that I finish the editing process and the last part of the video, everything comes out with this interface metallic sound that you hear in my videos. I apologize for that. I'm very sorry. And from now on, I'm gonna be recording with my iPhone, and currently I'm recording with my iPhone 6. So if you see any difference on the quality of my videos, it's because I'm recording with my iPhone. I can use my DSLR because I won't be able to import my videos into my iPhone and edit them from there, because I'm using my iPhone to edit my videos, and I'm also using my iPhone to record my video. Since I don't have the lightning cable that Apple came out with, not yet, so I have to do all this, okay? I have to use my iPhone to record and then to edit. So please bear with me with this quality. gonna have to hold on to that for now. I'm bringing you this blue makeup tutorial today because it was requested by one of my friends on Facebook. I posted a picture on Facebook and someone requested that I do the makeup tutorial for the look, and another person liked the comment and said, okay, yes, I also want the video. So here is the video. And even though you didn't ask for this tutorial, right, I hope you enjoy watching me create this tutorial. And yes, if you want to see how I create this look, all you gotta do is sit back and watch, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. To create an even canvas, I'm going to use NYX eyeshadow base, and it's basically white. And I'm going to apply it on my lower lash line as well. Then I'm going to blend it with my fingers. Then I'm going to set it with a white eyeshadow. Then I'm going to move on to my transition color using this light brown from my Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. And then I'm going to sweep it all around my crease just to make sure I have color right there. And then all the colors that I'm going to apply later can blend in easily. And I'm going to move on to a darker brown, and I'm focusing most of the time in my outer V area, and then I'm going to sweep the rest of the product in the brush on the rest of the eye, on the rest of the crease, okay? Then I'm going to make sure I blend it in very well. Then I'm gonna use this Benefit pencil. It's the high brow pencil, and I'm gonna use it in my inner tear duct to create that bright inner tear duct. And I'm gonna start with my first color, which is the yellow eyeshadow from this Wet n Wild palette. And then I'm going to move on into this green color. It might not look green on me right now, cause I don't like this eyeshadow very much, to be honest with you, but you know, you gotta work with whatever you have, and this is what I have right now. So I'm applying this green color. It's a really soft green color, and I'm making sure I blend all the edges, I mean like the edges of both color that I have on right now. Then I'm moving on into a blue one. That's the medium blue in that eyeshadow palette. And then I'm gonna do the same thing following the green. I'm going to apply the blue. The blue is gonna be basically on the center, the light blue is gonna be on the center, and then in the outer third I'm going to apply the darkest blue, which is the one that I'm applying right now, basically like overlaying the colors and making sure I blend them very well so that there's no harsh lines. And
As a final color, I'm going to apply this dark gray. It looks black, but it's not. It's actually very dark gray with a little bit of shimmer in it, but you cannot really see it. So I'm going to apply that to darken up my crease. Then I'm going to make sure I place the color where I want it to be. Later on, I'm going to move on into blending. I'm going to take a blending brush to blend all the edges of that eyeshadow. And this process can take long. You might not see the whole process in the tutorial, but you have to make sure you blend all the colors, all the edges together. You make sure that everything is well blended and it looking very nice where you want it to be. So I'm gonna put, as a brow bone highlight, I'm gonna use that matte shadow that I used to set my primer before, and then I'm gonna clean right there to create a sharper edge, so that also that cleaning process can help me when applying my eyeliner, which is the one that I'm applying right now. And I'm using the fill tip. This eyeliner, I believe, is Cyber Color. It's heavy rotation fill tip eyeliner. So yeah, I'm just going to apply my eyeliner. I have an eyeliner tutorial on my channel. I'm gonna leave that down below, the link to where you can watch that video if you have any problem lining your eye. That liner video is a very, very, very simple. I mean, like, the steps are very clear. So once I'm done with that, and in today's video, I am going to apply my lashes on camera for the first time. So you guys, please, 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 give me those thumbs up. Yay! I finally did it. I'm applying my lashes. These are the Allure lashes by Vicky Snape, the Grand Glamour lashes. So now we are moving on to the face. I'm gonna apply the Benefit Professional and on the areas that my pores are big, and then I'm going to move on into correcting. I'm using this concealer by MAC. I wasn't using it as a concealer and it was useless for me for a very long time, until I look at it again. I was like, you are too orange for me, so how about use you as a corrector. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm using my favorite all-time favorite concealer from NARS. This is a Monday. I don't know how you pronounce it. That's how I feel like I should pronounce it. How about that? So I'm spraying a Real Techniques sponge, and then I'm going to blend all that concealer in. And this is something that I just started doing, like apply my concealer first or my highlighter first, and then I'm going to apply my foundation later, because I find it easier to blend everything together at the end if I do it like that. So I'm gonna keep doing it like this. I'm using my Bobbi Brown foundation stick in the shade Almond 7, I believe. Yeah, and then I'm just applying it all over my face, and then I'm gonna still blending it with my Real Techniques sponge, making sure I get that neck. Don't want to have that line. So yeah, make sure you blend it very well. Now I'm gonna set all my highlighted area under my eye, the bridge of my nose, my cupid's bow. My chin, and then my forehead, which I didn't show, but I did set that. And then I'm going to use the CoverGirl collection in the shade Ebony, the bronzer from them, to bronze up my face. And I'm not contouring today, I'm just bronzing my face so that I can get some definition. And then I'm gonna use this Mary Kay powder foundation, loose powder foundation, to set my whole face, and then to swap away the banana powder off of my face. And then I'm going to contour my nose. I love this brush so much. I'm going to contour my nose a little bit. And I'm going to use this highlighter by Becker. It's the Skin Enhancer in the shade Opal. I love it so much. I can't believe how much I love this highlighter, and I never realized, you know, I've had it for too long, like 5 months now, but I've started to love it so much. So we are moving to the lower lash line, and I'm applying a very medium brown color to my lower lash line, and then I move on to the darkest brown color in that Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, and I sweep it there. And then I'm gonna take a pencil brush to fully blend in all the colors together. And then to darken up that area, I'm gonna use a pencil liner. And then right now I'm moving on to my lashes. Coat them with mascara. I love this mascara. It's by Sep Type of Color. And now I'm lining my lips using the Wet n Wild pencil liner. I don't know what is the name. This pencil is too old. I can't find the name. So I'm applying this lipstick. And this is it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoy it. Give me a thumbs up if you like this tutorial, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Love you. Stay beautiful.